Have you guys ever had a fantastic idea in your head, but when you tried to explain it to someone, it somehow turned out to be a complete mess? We asked our friend Jared to sketch his idea for a kids' watch featuring a maze game. However, his attempts at sketching to communicate the essence of it always fell short. But what if you can bring your idea to life within minutes just like this?
Hi, I'm Geraldine.
And I'm Suzie.
And we're here to share about our experience on engaging AI tools in our design process. With AI coming into the forefront of our lives, we as designers think it's essential to explore how we can engage and leverage AI tools like ChatGPT and Midjourney in our design process.
Not only ideate, but create really controlled outcomes with purpose and intention. Then, we'll also demonstrate on how you can create contexts that communicate the story and mood for any design idea you have.
When used correctly, we think AI can be used to visualize any cool idea and further your ideation process to help communicate more clearly and explore more deeply. Bring a new type of clarity and efficiency that a sketch may not be able to do.
Let's start with using ChatGPT as an ideation and validation tool. Here's an example. Geraldine, do you often find it troublesome to ask for a phone charger at a friend's house?
Yeah, especially when the other guests also need to charge their phones, and it becomes inconvenient to share because there's so many of us.
To come up with a solution, we questioned and asked ChatGPT to validate our design ideas before visualizing in Midjourney. We generated several conceptual ideas concurrently, asking what-if questions, like making it communal, portable, or visually interactive. We realized that although Midjourney is useful, we require our own design thinking capabilities to assess feasibility and improve on the design quality. However, at this stage, we as designers need to think more critically to evaluate and select compelling features to incorporate into the new design solution. We decided on wanting to create a charger that is communal and wireless for the convenience of every guest that needs to charge their phone at the same time. When prompting, we think having the ability to control the details of the generation is key. Thinking in design phases, we prompt in an orderly sequence for maximum control of the final outcome. Firstly, we had to create consistency in the form and design of a singular disk, making use of different commands on Midjourney to imagine, remix, and upscale. Using this order to prompt allowed us to get the most desirable design outcome. Then, as it's supposed to cater to multiple guests, our next challenge was to prompt a singular disk into a family set that extruded the same design language. These were made possible by adding reference images which contained the nuances of the design style and details we wanted in our design. After that, we used Photoshop to edit some of the features from the generations that had the most potential to create an even more detailed and high-quality outcome. We then put them back into Midjourney as reference images to prompt more feasible designs, before adding in context, background, and human interaction. Following this process, we managed to generate a realistic representation of a sleek and minimalistic wireless charging disk set that acts as the perfect addition to any social gathering at home. Being able to visualize realistic product details through Midjourney generations inspired us to think further and make more informed design decisions when ideating. But now, how do we decide what context setting would best represent this product?
Designing is not just about a product. Visualizing your design in various contexts can also help you enhance communication with your audience and reach better conclusions. For instance, imagine you want to showcase your headphones in an outdoor setting, like on a bridge railing. Based on these categories, the look of your image outcome would vary. Your prompt words would probably look something like this, highlighting the environment, product, image style, and lighting. But the result will most likely turn out weird with inaccurate angles and positioning. You can try inputting images based on your desired angle and position of the product. Using reference images can help you achieve a higher accuracy in your outcome, just like this. We were able to showcase and highlight our product in a beautiful composition. This technique allows you to freely create images that are immersive and engaging to your audience by showing it in different environments and when in use. We feel that understanding the way of AI tools empowers us as designers to boldly explore the various context settings before committing our time to professional rendering softwares. softwares like Keyshot and Blender can be tedious, and sometimes the outcome might not even turn out right after spending many hours on it. Using a same method, we can explore context for the charging solution mentioned earlier.
Creating a realistic rendering through Midjourney, which sets the mood and story of the product. It can quickly give us a better understanding of how it will fit into people's lives. Within minutes, we were able to envision our product in several contextual shots.
In conclusion, AI is a useful tool that can be leveraged to help us bring our creative vision to life in stunning detail and immersive context.
With AI as an assisting design tool, we can explore and communicate our ideas more effectively and create products that truly resonate with people.
We hope you enjoy our sharing and hopefully are excited to use AI tools the next time you design. Special thanks to our Professor Donn Koh for the guidance. Thanks, Donn! We'll be right back.